So Jesse from Adopt Me went ahead and hosted an hour and 30 minute Q&A video. I went ahead and grabbed the best questions with his responses in this video here. So if you appreciate me helping you out, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Let's get right to it.
Why did Cicatrices come back? Why not something new? So that's actually, this is a question I wanted to answer. So really, thank you for asking it. So these minigames are a lot of work, and they're really fun, and they're in the, I saw it shaking, I shouldn't have gone, and they're in the game for, you know, 2, 3, 4 weeks if it's a week one game, and then they're gone forever and they never come back. And we saw a lot of desire in the community. We saw a lot of messages from players saying they wish they could play the minigames again. For us, making them, like, it was really fun.
I get the impression they couldn't think of another game, so they went ahead and just decided to reuse this game. Think of it like this, they went ahead and saved a lot of time by just throwing in an old minigame, because can you only imagine how long it takes to create one? I don't blame them. I just wish they would have used an older game rather than last year's game. So be aware, they're probably going to be doing this for the Christmas, which I have no problem with, but please don't use last year's games.
Can we bring the evil unicorn back? So right now there are no plans to bring back pets that were on sale and have been removed from sale. In general, we encourage you to, you know, build up your inventory, work your way up in value, and trade with other players to get pets you want that are no longer obtainable.
So I'm happy to hear they're not bringing old items back. Imagine if they would bring in a bad dragon for you to purchase or become available. It would just kill the value of the bad dragons that we currently have. And, you know, you got to work for it. You got to trade up to it. That's a lot of the fun in Adopt Me. So that's good news.
We're going to bring back all the old eggs. Similarly, no current plans to bring back any old eggs, old pets, anything like that. What we have been doing is we've been doing those theme sections based on the old eggs, which has been a fun way to do new pets in some of the old themes that we played with a few years back. What do I think the next theme is? I know, and I'm not telling you, but I think if you're smart, I think if you puzzle it out, if you put on your best detective hat, you might be able to work it out. If you think you have, let us know.
Jesse, you totally just insulted me because I'm completely clueless and dumb. I have no idea what's coming next. Nah, I'm just playing. Chances are it's probably the Aussie egg is what I assume. Hopefully I'm right, because if not, I'm dumb, according to Jesse. Thank you.
Can we add a trading value icon? That's actually a really good question. That's a question we get asked a lot. It's like about trading values. And right now, again, never say never, but the last time I talked to someone about it, the thing that we kind of talked about and the thing that came up a lot is that, in general, we don't want to go too hard on that. Like, part of the fun of trading is trying to get good value, trying to, you know, decide what your pets are worth to you, what the pet you want is worth. I don't think there is an empirical trading value for each individual pet, you know?
So trading value would be really helpful for people that don't know how to trade and make it a little easier for you to just compare the trading value. But I feel like it would take a lot of the fun out of, like, big overpays that you may get, because that's kind of an exciting part of Adopt Me, that you just kind of like, wow, you got a big win. So I'm happy they're not doing any of that. Okay, they kind of just leave it for other people to kind of decide what the values are, which is I believe a good thing.
Will there be a new egg in November? I'm pretty happy to say no. There will not be a new egg in November. Halloween and winter events take up a lot of our time. They take a lot of work. I think it would be beyond our ability to be able to drop a new egg in the middle of that. So I think I'm safe to spoil that there won't be a new egg coming in November.
Thank God for that, because that means the urban egg will be there longer than 3 months. So the earliest we'd get a new egg would probably be in January. So we'll see about that.
Are the lures staying or leaving? Yeah, staying. The kind of big live event was about adding a new feature to the game. So lures, as they exist, are here, you know, for as long as we want them to be. No plans to remove them. What we might do in future is maybe, you know, I could see us adding new baits, new types of lures, new types of baits, new pets from the baits. I think there's loads of room for that to expand or refresh in the same way that we've refreshed things like the gift hats, the hat boxes, and the gifts. The way we, I think we refreshed Star Rewards once since they launched.
Please give me a flaming bear, a flaming unicorn, some type of flaming dragon, and we're good to go. Keep that in mind, Jesse.
Galaxy Gamer asks, do you have any plans to sell the game? Absolutely not. We love making Adopt Me. You know, making Adopt Me is what we do. And hopefully we do a pretty good job of it. No, we love to do this. It's what Uplift Games is built around. It's what our focus is. You know, our plan is to support Adopt Me for years to come.
So I know someone's out there like, who cares if they sell the game? It's very important. Think of it like this. If they sell a game to a greedy company, they'll put old items in the game, they'll put old eggs back in the game just for money, and it will totally ruin the experience. So I'm happy to know Adopt Me is here to stay for now.
What did you ask? I lost it. Oh, what's the max amount of bucks from Lords? It is 10,000, which apparently you got, so congratulations. That is very, very rare. That is not easy to get.
That's way too rich for my luck, man. I even check at night. Comment down below if you're the same. Waking up at 3 a.m. to check the lore. And then going to sleep crying because you got nothing good.
What's my favorite Halloween pet? Great question. It's this one, and you don't know what it is yet. I can't wait for you to find out. I'm so excited. I'm genuinely tempted to leak it now, but I'm not going to.
So when I first heard of this, I thought you were just full of it. I didn't think anything big of that pet, but once I saw it, I knew what the big deal was and why you were so hyped about it, so.
Will there be an RGB reward box refresh? I don't think we have one planned at the minute. I don't think that's in our plans, but as I always say, never say never. So I will keep my eye out for anything like that and follow player.me so you'll be the first to know.
I've been talking about it, I've been saying it, and the way he responded to the question also lets me know there's one on its way, so make sure you're storing your RGB boxes and you're keeping them stored away and ready for that refresh.
Do we have any plans to add Bucks Trading or x2 Pet Aging Game Pass? Not at the minute. I haven't heard any rumblings of either of those things. Bucks Trading, especially, I think is something we are super cautious about. I think it has the ability to change the game economy pretty heavily.
So I have 100,000 bucks on my account. I know someone that has 300,000 bucks on their account. So their chances are there's people with a lot more. And if they would just unleash that in the game, the rich would just be richer and the poor would just be poorer. So even though I would want it, I understand why they don't want to do that.
People asking about passcodes for backpacks. That's something we've looked at, I think, in the past. I don't believe we're adding passcodes. I think one of the issues is, while it can be helpful, it can go the other way. It would be awful if, say, you were to forget your passcode and then be locked out of your backpack. And potentially, you know, not be able to fix that.
So passcodes for backpacks would be an interesting idea. I think it's mostly for people that, like, brothers and sisters know your account. They go in and take your stuff. Having a backpack passcode would help prevent that. I think if you get hacked too, it would just be extra protection onto your account. These accounts are worth a lot of money, so that'd be an interesting idea. So we'll see what happens with it.
I can reveal exclusively that we do have some backpack improvements coming in the next few weeks, before the end of the year, is what I'm going to say. I think it's in the next few weeks, definitely before the end of the year. One of our engineers has been pulling together some amazing tweaks to the backpack that will help.
So two things I could think of when it comes to this is having an egg tab on your backpack and maybe having a neon or mega tab in your backpack so you could easily access them, I think would be a great idea.
Will we ever be able to equip more than one pet at once? That is a very common player desire. The answer is never definitely no, but that is another thing where we know players want it, we know it would be really fun. It has a lot of impacts we need to consider, like For example, just performance. A lot of players we know play on lower end devices or older devices. So we want to make sure the game still works for them. We don't want the servers to get too laggy to be able to play, which if we double the number of pets, there are some concerns there. So we would have to do some work around that.
So equipping a second pet totally makes sense on why they don't allow it. But you know what you could do? Just make a second account and play with that second account. It's that easy.
What's my fave game on Roblox? Easy. Adopt me. Put that on TikTok. Clip it.
That question is ridiculously funny because imagine if he would have said like Bed Wars or Banana Eats. This dude would be fired, man. Why are you asking that question? It's obvious. It's Adopt Me. Even though it may not be Adopt Me, you're choosing Adopt Me. Come on.
Trading age potions. Something we were talking about. Again, like, I think a pretty common player desire. Will we change that? Maybe. Let us know. Keep letting us know if you do want something like that. You know, being able to judge player desire for new features or changes to how we work is really, really, really important to making sure we are always considering them and thinking about them.
I don't think they'll ever do it because I've noticed that they don't want to impact the economy of the game. And I think they would have already done it when they released age potions and they didn't do it for a certain reason. I think that's why. So I don't think it's coming.
One question. Why do we change the update days? This is a great question. Why do we change them from Fridays to Thursdays? And the answer is players at the peak play on the weekends, right? Saturday and Sunday, you don't have school. You don't have work. You know, a lot of people anyway don't have work. It is like the prime time to sit down and grind Adopt Me. And one of the awful things was we would put an update out on a Friday, and then Saturday, when you sit down, you're like, finally, I get to play Adopt Me. I've got great plans for these new pets. And then we hit a bug that we hadn't caught. And suddenly that's ruining your Saturday. And, you know, maybe it gets fixed Saturday, maybe it doesn't get fixed till Sunday, maybe even Monday. That sucks. That's not fun. So part of the move to Thursday was it gives us Friday as a day basically to catch and fix bugs. So we can put it out Thursday. Anything that goes wrong with it, you know, once we suddenly unleash it to hundreds of thousands of players instead of our, like, you know, 50 playtesters or whatever.
So the real story about why they changed the date, at least in my opinion, is that when they released the update on Friday, a lot of people were working on Saturday to fix it, and they got upset because they had to work on a Saturday. And obviously, we don't want to work on Saturdays. You know, we want time to rest. So that's probably the reason why they changed it to Thursday, which I understand. I don't blame them. I don't want to work on a Saturday either. It's okay, Jesse. It's okay.
Is there going to be an advent calendar in the winter event? Here's what I'll say to you. Obviously, you have to wait and find out. Obviously. But I will tell you, people really liked it last year. So I think there's a pretty good chance that one's coming back. And maybe with some different things inside it. Who could say? Certainly not me. Oh, it feels so evil.
Jesse, that's not much of a tease, man. For sure, the advent calendar will be back this Christmas. You mentioned it a little bit earlier. You bring it back every year. So expect an advent calendar, and you want to make sure you log in every day. There you go, guys. That concludes the top questions in this Q&A video made by Jesse. You could check that out at Adopt Me YouTube channel. It's totally there if you want to see all the questions that were asked. I just picked the best ones. If this is your first time listening to me, I have a whole collection of Adopt Me videos, original Adopt Me videos. So please check that out. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. Give the video a thumbs up. I appreciate all the support. Thank you for watching. God bless you guys.